Pravin Isaria. I'm a clinical immunologist and a medical director for the COVID specialty immunization clinic in Kallur. The figure that is quoted about anaphylaxis to any vaccine is between 0.5 to 1 per million doses of vaccines administered. What was different with COVID vaccines is that since they were initially rolled out in December last year, the initial figures that were quoted from the phase 1 and 2 studies were close to about 11 to 12 per million. So that is what created such anxiety and a bit of an apprehension and also curiosity in medical fraternity as to what was indeed the cause of it. Interestingly, when they went back and looked at the first about, I think, 30 reported cases, when USFDA looked at it more closely, one signal that was evident was that most of these patients who had anaphylaxis, almost 90% of them, actually had history of allergy either to medication or to food or even to actually insect venom. So hence it was thought that history of having allergic reaction to foods or medications might be a predisposing factor to having anaphylaxis to this particular vaccine. As I said, there was a bit of a scientific curiosity as to why this is happening. And also on top of the scientific curiosity, there was also this apprehension that this might actually lead to some bit of vaccine hesitancy, because the prevalence of these allergies, food allergies and medication allergies, is very high in common population, and especially the self-reported can be as high as 10%. So we thought this is going to have some problems with the amount of people that could be vaccinated. And that's the time when we decided that we should set up the COVID specialty immunization clinic, so that there is a pathway for people who might be apprehensive to take it in a mass vaccination clinics. What we found was that with the phase 1A rollout, which was, you know, the healthcare workers mainly, as well as the airport workers and the medi hotel workers, is that there was a quite high incidence of self-reported allergies. But amongst the first 200 that we vaccinated in our clinic, there was not one anaphylactic reaction. So that made us start thinking as to this was most likely going to be a false alarm. So to look into it further as to what exactly might be causing these allergies, we decided to actually look up, and we had two patients on our books already who had history of allergic reaction to PEG, so which is polyethylene glycol. So that is one of the excipient that is used in the mRNA vaccine, the Pfizer vaccine. And it was thought that it is this excipient which was causing the anaphylaxis. That was the hypothesis at that moment. So what we did was, we actually thought that we should possibly investigate. Now, it is very hard to find PEG allergic individuals. So thankfully, we had two people that we had seen late last year in my clinic. And then we saw one through the screening program that we had for the Kallur phase 1A rollout. So we picked them up and we did three things with it. One is, there was already international publications on the skin prick and the intradermal, so basically allergy testing workup that needs to be done for these individuals. So the first thing was, we decided on these three individuals to check and see whether those protocols that were being developed in these people, who are the ones which are most highly likely to get an allergic reaction, how do they perform in them? And lo and behold, they performed very, very below par. So then we thought that we need to invest, then what would be the right way to do it? So we investigated skin prick and intradermal testing to the vaccine itself, which was positive. So which means that all these three individuals were indeed allergic to Pfizer vaccine. Now, we have had a research interest in one of these allergic tests called basophil activation test. So it is a test whereby you can actually do a challenge testing, but not in by giving the allergen to the individual itself. So what you do is, you actually draw the blood out from the individual who might be allergic to it, and then you expose these allergy cells in them to this particular, to the particular allergen, and to see if these basophils get activated or not. If they get activated, now ideally the gold standard of allergy testing is, you would actually do this with the person himself. So we will get them into our day unit, you will give them the allergy and see if they react. So you can imagine that is quite risky, very lengthy procedure and requires lots of resources. So we are trying to develop a system whereby you could do that on patients' blood so that they are not exposed to that risk. And we've been trying to do this for the last 2 years. So we use that particular test in these individuals to answer what specific component of the vaccine they might be allergic to. And what has really got us excited is that it is not the PEG alone which is responsible for causing these anaphylactic events with this vaccine. It is the pegylated lipid nanoparticle. Now, I know it's a mouthful, but what it means is it is a scaffolding protein that is used to encase this mRNA so that it can be effectively delivered to your immune system. And it is this scaffolding or this covering of the actual vaccine which is what is responsible for causing these allergic reactions. So what we got published in JACI, which is the highest ranking immunology and allergy journal worldwide, is because of these two things. One, possibly we've said that the skin testing protocol is no good. The second, we've said it might possibly is not allergic to PEG, and it is the pegylated lipid nanoparticle which is used, which is responsible for this. And most importantly, we've said that, you know, this is very specific, and hence we don't need to worry about the single food allergies or drug allergies, which was initially flagged late last year. What it basically means is that if you are just allergic to like single penicillin or some nut allergy or any other food allergies, don't worry at all. You can go yourself, get vaccinated, rest assured in any mass vaccination clinic, your chances of getting an allergic reaction are no more than any other individual. You are not at an increased risk. If you do have history of allergic reaction to multiple medications, so which are unrelated, then possibly it could still be excipient allergy, in which case then we would want to see you in our COVID specialist immunization clinic.